I decided we're going to start on time, and the other commissioners will be coming. Commissioner Reinhart, Chair of the Board, unfortunately is a bit under the weather and under doctor's orders to stay home and get well. And so I am substituting for her tonight. Thus, on behalf of you, I welcome you to the 2017 Truth and Taxation Public Hearing. This is the speech she was going to give. Victoria represents District 7, Maplewood, North St. Paul, White Bear, and the Hillcrest area of St. Paul. On behalf of my colleagues who are sitting along the wall here of the board, the Ramsey County staff is here, and I would like to welcome you to this annual Ramsey County budget hearing and open house. I'd like to introduce you to your Ramsey County commissioners. Please stand as I introduce you. Blake Huffman, District 1. Arden Hills, Gem Lake, North Oaks, Badness Heights, White Bear Township, parts of Mounds View, Spring Lake Park, and Blaine. Mary Jo McGuire, District 2. Lauderdale, Little Canada, New Brighton, Roseville, St. Anthony, and the Precinct 4 in Mounds View. Janice Rippon, that's me. I represent District 3, Falcon Heights, and parts or all of the following St. Paul neighborhoods: Payne Phelan, North End, South Como, Como Park, Frogtown, and Hamlin Midway. Tony Carter, District 4. She serves all.
She's on the air right now.
She's coming in as we. Tony Carter, serving all or parts of the following St. Paul neighborhoods: Crocus Hill, Denoyer Park, Hamlin Midway, Highland Park, Lexington Hamlin, McAllister Groveland, Merriam Park, Snelling Hamlin, Summit Hill, St. Anthony Park, and Summit University. It should be noted that Commissioner Carter has a family situation that, and this has already been set up, that she has to leave around 7:30, so this has been set up long before this. Rafael Ortega, District 5, serving all or parts of the following neighborhood, is Rafael? Stand up. All are part of the following. McDonough, District 6, Dayton's Bluff, the East Side, Hayden Heights, Hazel Park, Payne Phelan, and Sunray Battle Creek. Now I'd like to preview tonight's schedule before handing the meeting over to Commissioner McDonough, who is Chair of the Budget Committee. After the formal budget introduction by Commissioner McDonough, Ramsey County Deputy County Manager of Information and Public Records, Joanna Berg. There she is, right there. We'll give a brief presentation on the budget and property taxes. Then we will ask for your input. We thank you for being in attendance tonight. If you would like to give your public testimony on the budget or property taxes, we are here to listen to you. Each person who would like to have 2 minutes to address the board members at the microphone. Our moderator tonight is Rick Cunningham. There he is in back. He will be giving you more details about the process after the budget presentations. We want to allow everyone who wishes to have an opportunity to speak. We won't be answering questions from the stage, but staff and or commissioners will be available for conversation after the program. It should be noted, if you are only here to ask a question about your property tax statement and property valuation, you may prefer meeting with a county assessor or his staff at this time. If this applies to you, please go ahead and see Katie, who's at the door. She is to be waving, okay? We appreciate you, Katie, waving, and so people can contact you if they'd like to speak directly to you. As board chair, Victoria would like to let you know that my colleagues and I work hard to balance the community's need for quality service delivery with the ability to pay. Ramsey County provides many essential services to our residents, from social services to emergency management and communications, to parks and libraries, to public safety and law enforcement, to public health, public works, and more and more. We are always mindful of property taxes and do our best to be resourceful in identifying and successfully applying for other sources of revenue, such as federal and state funds. This year, we are considering an overall 4.3 property tax levy increase for Ramsey County. We know that for some of you, as in some of the neighborhoods that continue to rebound from the property, from their recession, your property values are going up and that you see a larger property tax increases as well. Deputy County Manager Joanna Berg will walk us through how the market and other factors can affect the tax shifts between these different types of properties. Again, I thank you for taking the time out of your schedules, your night, to join us this evening. Ramsey County Budget Committee Chair McDonough will now present to you an overview of the 2018 budget. Thank you so much for being here.
Good evening and welcome. Your presence here is important. Tonight I respectfully submit the proposed Ramsey County budget for public comment. This is the second opportunity for the public to comment on our budget. This fall, the Ramsey County Board of Commissioners approved a maximum property tax levy of $299,301,751 to finance the 2018 budget, which calls for a total spending of $712,034,499. In your packets, you will find graphs and tables that show in detail how our budget funds Ramsey County services for residents. Safety and justice, health and wellness, economic growth and community investment, information and public records and administration. Of the overall proposed budget increase of $20.9 million, $12.7 million would come from property taxes. This reflects a property tax levy increase of 4.3%. As Commissioner Redman said in her opening, we make every effort to provide Ramsey County taxpayers with essential services at an affordable cost. We take our responsibilities very seriously as stewards of residents' hard-earned money and work to craft budgets that are cost-effective, frugal, and predictable without uneven variations in the levy year to year. The county is in a strong financial standing as evidenced by the fact we are one of the few counties nationwide holding a AAA bond rating from the top rating agencies and have held this rating since 2001. Essentially, this is like having a great credit score. It allows us to spend less when we need to borrow money, such as borrowing money for this great facility investment in the community right here in Shrewsbury Public Library. After we hear from you this evening, final budget approval by the board will occur on December 12th. The final approved property tax levy may not exceed the maximum levy set in September, but it may be lower. Changes to the budget may occur by action taken by the board, but there will be no increase in the levy as a result of these changes. As we consider the 2018 budget, we have done our best to make fiscally prudent decisions about investments in our communities. providing for public safety and protecting the most vulnerable of our citizens, while never forgetting that citizens and businesses will need to pay for those services. We're here tonight to listen. Thank you for your time and consideration. We look forward to your comments and suggestions. At this point, I would like to introduce Joanna Hurd. She will take us through an overview presentation about the budget and property taxes. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I have about a 15-minute presentation, and then we will move into the public hearing. This presentation and the public hearing are being streamed through Facebook Live, and a link is available at ramseycounty.us/public-hearings. Four topics I'm going to cover tonight: an overview of the budget and Ramsey County property trends, an orientation to the property tax statement, and highlighting some refund programs. At the highest level, the Ramsey County proposed budget supports our strategic policy goals, which are well-being, prosperity, opportunity, and accountability. All of the work that we do in Ramsey County ties in some way to these goals, and this information is among the data available to you in your packets. Walking through an overview of the budget timeline, the process begins in March each year when property value notices are mailed. You may recall receiving this mailing. It included coupons to pay your property taxes in 2017, as well as the projected valuation of your property in 2018. Departments and service teams work with the county manager to develop a proposed budget, which the county manager presented to the Ramsey County Board on August 8th. Throughout the month of August and September, departments had hearings on their budgets. These were held in downtown St. Paul. All of them were video recorded and are available to you through our website. On September 12th was the first of our two budget public hearings. That was also video recorded and is available on our website. On September 26th, commissioners set the county's maximum levy amount. And earlier this month, we began mailing property tax notices. We're here tonight at the second of two public hearings. Commissioners will be listening to your comments about the proposed budget and will deliberate on them as they move forward towards a vote on December 12th that will adopt the final budget. Overall, the 2018 proposed budget is $712 million to fund our programs. This is a total budget increase of 3% over 2017 and a levy increase of 4.3% over 2017. We budget Ramsey County on a two-year cycle, and this is the first year of that two-year budget. I'm going to talk a little bit about county revenues and county expenditures. We look here at the where the county dollar comes from. I'm going to start on the left side of the pie. You'll see that intergovernmental revenue, which is in blue, and charges for services, which is in yellow, are about half of our county's revenue. Intergovernmental revenue includes federal and state tax dollars. Many of the programs we provide through the county are funded through federal and state dollars. Charges for services are wide and varied. They include everything from fines here at the Ramsey County Library to contracts that the Sheriff's Office does with suburban communities to provide policing services. About 10% of our revenue is from other sources, and what isn't collected from any other source is collected through property taxes, about 42% of the county's revenue. The overall property tax levy is $299 million. That is the number that is proposed to increase 4.3%. That 4.3% does not apply to individual properties, but rather is the sum of taxes on all 157,000 some properties in Ramsey County. In other words, the $299 million is spread among all of the taxable properties in the county. When we look at county spending, starting on the right side of the pie, you see that health and wellness constitutes almost half of county's spending. Health and wellness is one of the service teams that the county is organized into. Service teams consist of departments, and within health and wellness, we provide services such as public health, social services, financial services, community corrections, and veteran services. Moving clockwise around the pie, safety and justice includes the sheriff, the county attorney, the 911 center, the medical examiner. Economic growth and community investment includes public works, parks and recreation, the libraries, and various workforce programs. Administration is the nuts and bolts that runs the county. Information and public records includes elections, county auditor, treasurer, county assessor, information technology, and communications. The next slide shows some of our funding priorities in the 2018-2019 budget. This material is also available in your packet, and I'm going to move through it quickly here. If you have additional questions about any of these priorities, please feel free to speak to any of the county staff here this evening. We'd be glad to answer those questions. The first overall budget priority is funding enhanced community services. An example of investments in this area is redirecting people with mental health conditions from the criminal justice system with services that will provide improved outcomes as well as reduce long-term costs. The second funding priority area is funding improvements in public safety. An example of this is continuing and expanding the Start by Believing criminal sexual assault prevention initiative. The third priority area is funding our workforce and business modernization. An example of this is expanding early voting and the need to meet our anticipated cost increases related to the 2018 election. And finally, funding capital assets and economic development. An example of which are investments in our Public Works Department for maintenance and construction projects on county roads and bridges. I'm going to move that into an overview of property trends in Ramsey County. We know that our taxes are tied to our property values as well as the levies of taxing jurisdictions. Taxing jurisdictions include Ramsey County as well as the city and school district in which your property is located and the Metropolitan Council. The assessed values of properties are driven by the real estate market. The recession that hit in 2009, we are still recovering from that recession, and properties are rebounding neighborhood by neighborhood through Ramsey County as foreclosed properties have been sold and have been improved. This year in particular, the North End neighborhood is experiencing this snapback on values, bringing properties there back to pre-recession levels. Commercial tax rates are higher than residential tax rates, but across all market sectors, commercial, residential, and apartments, we are seeing values rebounding across the county. St. Paul property owners are seeing changes in how they pay for street assessments. This applies to St. Paul property owners only. This does not have have an effect on the county's budget or county property taxes, which is what tonight's public hearing is about. But I wanted to call this out in this presentation because some of you from St. Paul may have questions about this. We've included the flyer that the city produced on this for your information. That's available in your packets and on the table. We've also linked to it on our public website at ramseycounty.us/public-hearings. If you wish to speak at a public hearing for the city of St. Paul, their public hearing, very similar to this one, will be held on December 6th at 6:30 p.m. at the City Hall in downtown St. Paul. Now I'm going to go through your property tax statement. We're using as our example here this evening a median valued home in St. Paul. You see the 2017 estimated market value of $161,400 and the 2018 estimated market value of $173,900, a value increase of 7.7%. Proposed tax on this property is $2,502. This is the step we are at this evening. Beginning in March of 2018, the cycle begins again with the new valuation notices being mailed. And we're here tonight to listen to your feedback on the proposed levies. Moving through the tax statement, we're focusing tonight on the Ramsey County tax levy. You see here the 2017 actual tax on this median value St. Paul home and the 2018 proposed Ramsey County tax. Your tax statement, the county tax increase is $40.80 or 5.8%. Your statement then goes through the city that your property is located in and provides the meeting location for your city, the school district, location for the school district. Again, because we're using a St. Paul median valued property as our example, these are the city of St. Paul and the St. Paul school district. If you lived in Shoreview, your city and your school district would be reflected here, Roseville, etc. We have Metropolitan Council, their public meeting, coming down for this median-valued home to a total increase of $262.40, about 11.7%. Remember that $262.40, about $40 of that increase is attributable to Ramsey County. This grid is really here just for your reference. It's in your packets again if you'd like to read the detail. We walked through the St. Paul median value home. This grid shows trends for median value homes in suburban Ramsey County, as well as for commercial properties in St. Paul and the suburbs. As Commissioner Redman referenced, tonight we have county appraisers here who are available to discuss any questions that you have about the valuation process or about property-specific questions or concerns that you may have. We also want to ensure that you are aware of special property tax programs, both for 2017 and looking ahead to 2018. There's some detail about the programs here, and additional information about refunds is available in your packets. In addition to the refunds that are highlighted here, there are other programs available for military veterans, as well as for blind and disabled individuals. While it is counties that collect property taxes, it's the state of Minnesota that issues the refunds. We'll start the public hearing in a moment. Commissioners will listen to your testimony about the budget. They will not be answering questions. As I referenced, if you're here with questions about your property tax statement or the valuation process, county appraisers are available down the hall to talk to you tonight. If you have specific questions about your property, you may need to go away and do some research and come back to you later this week, but please do start the conversation with them this evening. I welcome anybody who wishes to speak to an appraiser to catch Katie, if you can wave one more time, and she's glad to escort you to their location. Finally, for those of you who are following us on Facebook Live, please review our social media policy regarding comments. And if you wish to provide public testimony, please do so through the online form available at ramseycounty.us/public hearings. Again, that's ramseycounty.us/public hearings. Comments left through Facebook will not be entered into the public record. Please do use the online form to provide comments. With that, I invite commissioners to the table, and I will introduce Rick Cunningham, who will be our moderator this evening.
While our commissioner and county manager are being seated, could I just ask if there's an empty chair next to you, could you just raise your hand? And then also, these are empty chairs here. So if anyone would like to sit down, please feel free to get them back. Well, good evening. I'm Rick Cunningham. I work in training and development in our health and wellness service team at Ramsey County. And a good evening to our county commissioners, our county manager, county staff, and a special good evening to all of you. It's a wonderful turnout. Thank you for being here this evening, and I'm grateful to help moderate the public hearing part of the meeting tonight. I do want to take just 3 or 4 minutes for some general announcements before we have people get up to speak. And first of all, I would say, we thought with the acoustics in the room, we didn't need a microphone, so I'll speak without a mic. Those giving comments, we'll have you come up to the center aisle. I'll mention that in a minute, and we'll just speak without microphones. We think that will work. And as mentioned, the purpose of the meeting tonight is for you to express comments about the proposed 2018 budget, so our county commissioners can consider them before passing the final budget. And in a moment, I'll review that process for those who would like to speak. But again, just a few words about the unique format tonight. As Joanna mentioned, our county commissioners are here to listen to your comments without responding to them or answering questions. Again, they simply want to listen. 2 quick general comments. The first is we want to thank our partners at Metro Transit for a special accommodation tonight. So for those of you riding the bus, if you're looking to take the bus back down Rice Street, down Route 62, a bus will be leaving about 15 minutes at the conclusion of the public hearing. You can catch it right outside the library main door. And then second, there is some information on the counter up in the front of the room on your left regarding Ramsey County. If you'd like to look at that information, you're most welcome after the hearing concludes. Now, for those who would like to speak tonight, the process is straightforward. If you'd like to comment but haven't signed up yet, we're going to first have those speak who signed up, and then we'll call on others who didn't sign up who would like to express comments, and I'll let you know when the time for that is. We have a tailor that you can see is signing, and we also have other interpreters in the room. So I'm going to have them hold up their hand. Spanish will be Oscar. Oscar, where are you? If you feel that you would like Oscar to interpret, we'll invite you to go see Oscar now. Also, Saeed will be interpreting Somali. There's Saeed. And Katrina, where are you? For Hmong. So if you want an interpreter, that's where they're located. Feel free to go over to them now. Now, if you don't wish to speak but have comments that you want heard tonight, please see Chris, and Chris will give you a comment card. I'd be happy to read that for you. Finally, for those that will be commenting, I have the list now, and we'll begin in just a moment or so. You'll be speaking right from here. You can't miss it. It's an X on the floor. We ask that you come up, introduce yourself by name and address, and simply address our county commissioners. Each person will have 2 minutes, as has been expressed, and that's to provide equal time and adequate time for everyone. We'll alert you with a chime and a sign that says 30 seconds. When there's 30 seconds remaining, you'll hear the chime. It'll just sound like that, and when the end of the 2 minutes comes, you'll hear a couple of chimes. And another sign that says your time is up. And I'll help us hold to the 2 minutes, but I certainly want to do that respectfully. Finally, we want to mention some common sense general guidelines to help us all. Of course, mutual respect and courtesy are the hearing's guiding principles. And also in that spirit, we ask all of us to turn off our cell phones, or at least set them to vibrate, if you can do that now, if you haven't. And we also ask for quiet so all of us can hear each speaker. And then finally, we also ask that a speaker not be interrupted. So with that, let's begin. And the first person that I think has signed up tonight is Bill Madden. Bill, are you here? Bill, we'll have you separate over here. Thank you for being here. And your name and address.
Bill Madden, 2203 Como Avenue, St. Paul.
Great, Bill. And your comments, please.
The comments are the reconstruction project on Como took us by surprise with an absolutely enormous assessment. And then that coupled with property tax increase on top of that. So I did some numbers, and I figured out in the last 15 years, the property taxes have increased 7.8% each year on my property, yet the home value increased 5.6%. So I would like to know why that increase is so much greater than the home value increase. And second, my father has a house that's literally twice the size, and Mendota Heights pays about 30% less taxes. So we started talking about that, and we realized, you know, a lot of the inner ring suburbs use St. Paul amenities. Is there some way that we can communicate so that they can somehow set up a system or proposal that perhaps these inner ring suburbs can help pay for some of the taxes of St. Paul, use of the streets and that kind of thing. But my concern is it's just raised so much that it could push us out of the city, which is so much love.
Thank you, Bill. Next that signed up is Joyce Thompson. Joyce, are you here?
I am here.
Yeah, please, thank you.
Let me stand back just a little bit. I know I had a little bit of difficulty
hearing
because one's voice is going this way and other people can't hear.
Great. Thank you for that.
I'm Joyce Thompson. I live at 4746 Victoria Street, North of Shoreview. What I've seen over the years is whenever the property values start going up, which we all like, everybody jumps on the bandwagon. Perhaps the county, the city, the schools, everybody, yay! We can increase the taxes because the property is going up. This does not mean more disposable income for we, the taxpayers. We can't chop off a wall in our house and sell it and have more money in that way. And yet when property values drop down, it's like, oh no, we can't drop, you know, the property taxes. We have those monies all allocated out. So you're kind of talking out of both sides of your mouth, and I think that's being dishonest to we property owners. And I also read in the thing that it's probably going to be approximately the same amount that's going to increase the following year as well. I know my Ramsey County portion is going up 7.2%, and my overall one city and county and everything's in there is going to be 11%. And you know, we property owners don't have the luxury as the county commissioners to vote themselves a $2,000 pay raise to help pay for that, to alleviate the pain. We property tax owners have the pain of that. I want you to know we are not your ATM machine, and it feels like you think we are.
Joyce, thank you for your comments. We had someone that didn't want to speak but offered a comment. George Smolchek, I hope, George, I got close to your name. What is it? Close enough. On Highland Drive, 4272 Highland Drive. And the answer will be posted on the website, Grants County website, public hearing. But the question was, what is Regional Railroad Authority fee? What is that fee? And again, that information will be posted. So thank you for that. I wonder if there are others who would like to make comments, and we'll maybe have a couple of you come up so that we're ready with comments. Is there anyone else that would like to comment? I don't want to assume that. Yes, please. Come on right up. And again, just your name and your address.
I'm Dennis Chisholm, 1386 Park Street, St. Paul. Everybody's been talking about 11%. This must be a misprint, though. It says 22. So that was a $300 increase last year and $340 this year. And I'm better off than most of the people on my block. And that's what my concern is those people that are probably 4 hours into their second job. Kids, their oldest kids or older kids are working, and you know that, and my niece, with that increase last year, she almost lost her house because she didn't have any savings. So the rest of us pitched in and helped her get over the bump. But until it bumps in the road, you know. And the only other thing I was wondering is, with the Super Bowl coming in 3 months, and they're saying billions of dollars poured into the economy of St. Paul and Minneapolis, does that mean our property taxes can go down, or do we just continue to get taxed whether the economy's booming or not? You know, just two concerns, and I'm wondering if I should have got my statement already. This thing was misdirected. Thank you.
And invite you also to check with our tax assessors in the back of the room who might be able to help following the public hearing. Is there anyone else that would like to offer comments? Yes, please, ma'am.
My name is Deb Lutchen. I live at 970 Armstrong Avenue in St. Paul. I bought my house in 1990 for $93,000. Now its market value is $165,000. I am disabled. I'm on Social Security. And my property tax went up this year 35.8%. I don't get a 35% rate increase. I'm lucky if I get a 3%. I asked some people, official people, about this. They told me, well, you can move. That was their response to me. I've lived here all my life. I've worked local jobs, and now I'm being forced out of my home. I don't think it's right. Thank you.
Thank you for being here today. Yes, please.
Yes. Hi, Commissioners. My name is Laura Cease. I live at 823 Howell Street North in St. Paul. I bought the house last year in September, and I was really excited to get it. I'm a single mom, just my income. My daughter's going to college in Bloomington, and I was flabbergasted to get my property tax statement showing that I'm getting a 53% increase based on the valuation of my home. It went up $50,000 in value apparently between 2017 and 2018. I don't know how that's possible. I did have a commissioner come out, and he said it was just because there were some improvements done, and they weren't noticed until after the house was listed for sale, and I made a mistake buying it. I do feel it's a mistake. I love the house I'm in, but this is probably going to force me out. I don't think I can even afford it. It's almost $1,000 difference, and I don't know how I'm going to do it. I may have to rent it out or just lose my home entirely. So I hope you guys can make really, really careful decisions, because I did not get a 53% increase in my income. I don't know how I'm going to do this. Thank you.
I appreciate your comments.
Anyone else?
Yes, sir.
Thank you to the gal back there. I think the property taxes, the problem is the formula that they use. I was up there 5 years ago because it was so out of whack, and I talked to the appraisers and everything, and we thought we had things hashed out. But 2 years ago, my property done out was worth
$335,000.
You're going to lie. That's fine. You're doing fine. John Ferguson, 337 South Alaska. 2015, they raised my property taxes $20,000 to $335,000. Last year it was up $20,000. And I just figured, well, that's okay. The real estate's going up. Everybody's going up $20,000. You know, I can handle that. Well, then this year I got the surprise when I opened it up. So I live on a row in Roseville that has seven homeowners. So I went to research all seven of them, and I'm the house in the middle. The first house went down $900. What's wrong with that picture in an up market? The second house went down $200. What's wrong with that picture? The third house went down $400. Mine's the fifth house, and it went up $50,300. The next house was even, no up, no down. And the one on the far end went down $5. Well, there's something wrong with that. I called the tax department, left my name, number, and address, and they said, somebody will call you back. That was last week. I'm glad I wasn't sitting by the phone. I have an answering machine, no question. No. The questions didn't get answered. I left the message there. They didn't call back. I guess I'm looking for suggestions from you guys. How do you actually get information? And that formula does not work. It never has worked, and I just showed you right here out of seven homeowners. It doesn't work. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any other comments? We'll take this gentleman in the back and then to you.
Name is Ryan Orchard. Live at 773 Michael Hart in St. Paul. I'm just going to jump on the bandwagon because mine went up 40%. In 1 year, and something I noticed with the presentation and everything else that the budget goes up 4.3, but yet there's a huge disproportionate tax increases that are well above the 4.3. My recommendation or suggestion is to figure out a way to either cap it or somehow correlate it much more closer to the budget than have it so skewed and off base, in my personal opinion. Mm-hmm. So thank you.
Thanks for your comments. Yes, sir.
My name is Dan Barthel. I live at 2792 Keller Parkway in Canada. I moved there in 2015, and I'm already considering having a move. The core reason for that is property taxes. When we were doing our expense predictions, we were expecting, since the house is on the lake, I think it was about $500 a month in property tax payments. But between 2016 and 2017, that doubled to $1,000 a month. That caught my bank off guard as well in the tax escrow. So they had to they had to cover it. And then now I'm also being charged for that. So now I have $1,500 a month in payments goes to taxation specific. As you've heard from everyone here so far, It's not necessarily the absolute numbers that are problematic, but it's the expense volatility that's a big problem. So after 2 years, that's what I've seen. What's next?
Appreciate your comments. Yes, sir.
My name is Mark DeClaire. My wife and I live at 406 Lakota Street in Lowertown. Our taxes went up. Well, my place was appraised at $231,300 last year. It was appraised at $280,000 this year. There's nothing in our building, the size unit that I have, that's sold for. Nothing. So we are going to be priced out of it. We just bought this a year ago. Love the area. Love St. Paul. Thought we'd spend our years in St. Paul. If the kids are growing up and we go, we're not going to be able to stay. We're going to have to leave St. Paul if this kind of thing continues. And I'm trying to find out, I just know the assessors, how is this happening? Who says that my property is worth $280,000? I just bought it 13 months ago for $250,000. If my property went up that much money, I would be delayed. It didn't. I can't sell it for what Ramsey County says it's worth. I can't even get close. Thank you.
I appreciate you being here. Thank you. Yes, sir, and then we'll come over to you.
Rendell, I live at 158 Long Boulevard in St. Paul. I've lived there for 50 years, and I can appreciate what these previous 10 people have said. My taxes have gone up this year 26%, and with that, what the city has done with the trash system, which is going up 100% for me, it's kind of worse than that. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, please. My name is Kevin Seeger. I'm a commercial property owner on Grand Avenue in St. Paul, 1059 Grand, and also a small business person. I own the two businesses that occupy that space. So my taxes went up 17.5%, as your picture indicated there, your slide indicated, and I will try to talk to an assessor about it. I had a comment, though. What my comment is this: as a small business person, the taxes in St. Paul, the taxes that we're going to see, which is what it means to me, is a little over $10,000 a year is what my taxes will be going up next year. You can't stay in business that way as a small business person. So what's happening to this business world, what's happening in my world, is that everybody is being driven to work for these large companies that can afford these taxes, afford health care, and afford everything else. But you all are participating in the problem. The problem is small businesses can't afford this. And the burden, it looks like, from, I don't know the breakdown of that, the 17.5%, how that looks at your budget. But I think what needs to happen, and there's nothing wrong with working for all three halves of the world, but that's where everybody is going to end up working. Because as you drive up and down Grand Avenue, there are very few business people left like me. And because of this tax increase, it's going to continue to erode. And so when you take and look 5 years down the road, 10 years down the road, why are there only J. Crews around? Why are there only businesses that are large businesses? The reason is because the spending that's going on and the burden that's being placed on businesses. You know, I don't know what people think, but businesses cannot afford all these increases. I employ about 20 people. So next year I have to come up with another $10,000 to send into for taxes on that property. And it's going to have to come from somewhere. And over the last 5-10 years, most of it's been coming out of what I make at that business. And it's getting really thin, and it just drives people out of business. So I hope you realize that what you're doing is you're driving people to work for large companies that can afford all of this. And at the end of the day, that's what it's going to look like. And it's unfortunate. Appreciate your comments. Thank you. Others who would like to offer comments to our county commissioners?
Yeah, I hadn't prepared anything, but just following up on what this gentleman from Grand Avenue has to say, I'm kind of a businessman, person, and then I'm a landlord. I own one duplex on St. Clair Avenue. I live on another duplex on St. Clair Avenue. I bought one of them for 180 $55,000 was a fixer-upper, and now you've just raised a $72,000 evaluation, all the way up to $342,000. The increase in taxes just in that building is going to be $1,600 a year. Now, what we haven't talked about are all these little renters out there that rent from us, small duplex people. How do I pass this on to them? And if they can't afford it, what are they going to do? The renters I have, they're usually two females, professional females, or males. They can't, one can't afford an apartment by themselves, so they live together. And now, if I try to pass this on to them, I mean, it's kind of breaking my heart to even do that. I don't think they can afford it. So if they can't afford it, the only way for me to keep them is to eat more of this cost myself. Now, we don't like to be in the business to lose more money every year to a taxing authority. That's the way it seems to come here. Either I eat it or they eat it, and if they can't eat it, they're going to move. And you know, we've been talking this mantra about affordable rent in St. Paul and probably the rest of the county for all these years, and but we have a reverse effect here by raising these property taxes this high. So I don't know what else to do with it, but thank you for your time.
Thank you, sir. Other comments from anyone? No? Yes, please.
Hi, my name is Jim Borden, 1963 Fairmount in the Ag Groveland area. I have an article here from the Strip from 1617 that said the St. Paul taxes would go up 23.9%. But in reality, they went up in St. Paul, let's see, 34%, because the value of the house went up $48,000 in 1 year. And I'm not sure exactly how you determine that, if you're looking at knockdown houses that people get, people who are coming from Texas or something like that, or executives will pay $600,000. There's some of those houses in the neighborhood, but the old houses with small rooms that aren't remodeled to that effect really don't have that kind of value. So I think this is kind of, the whole thing is kind of disingenuous.
Thank you for your comments. Others have not spoken?
My name is George Swalchick. I live at 4272 Highland Drive here in Shoreview. The only thing I want to say is, my gosh, am I a lucky guy. Based on what I've heard about you, about the value of this house, this $50,000 increase in a year is ridiculous to anybody. Secondly, on top of that, we've got a school levy. I don't know if that 17% or 4% or anything includes that levy now that you have to pay. The school taxes have passed. Am I correct? I may be wrong. School levy passed. Correct. So you're going to have that on top of that. Then, in addition to that, we are now going to be paying for, since Washington County and Ramsey County went into an agreement to process your garbage in a different way, no telling what that's going to run. So you had increases on three levels. So it's kind of hitting everybody in the pocket pretty good. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Other comments? Yes, please.
I'm Margaret Hibbard, and I live in 1850 in Falcon Heights. And I have three quick comments. One is, why did the homestead exclusion value change? That was it went from 12,100 to, no, it went up from 12,100 from 9,700. And then I had an 18% tax increase, and on the back it talks about you may get some refunds if your property taxes increase more than 12%, and I'm wondering how that comes back if someone can
ask, after hearing these stories that we, tonight, is that we did treat it, Ramsey County treats us, the citizens, with a little more compassion and empathy than we do get treated. And I'll give my personal example. It was 3 years ago. I suppose I was lucky this year, 11% tax rate is up. But 3 years ago, it was 38%. And I was told when I asked about that and complained, I was told, well, that's too bad. You've been getting a free ride for the last couple of years. This is just ketchup. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, sir. Others, whether you're speaking or not, we appreciate your participation and being here. Are there other people that would like to comment?
Sir, who are you anyway? Are you the chair of the board, or?
No, I'm not. I'm just moderating the public hearing part of our meeting tonight. I'm Rick Cunningham. I work for Ramsey County.
Okay. Why aren't they having the board run the meeting? I mean,
yes,
that's
odd. Yes, this is a unique format. We mentioned that at the beginning. The format is for our commissioners to simply listen, note, hear comments, and not respond tonight. So that's
When are they going to respond? I'm confused on that.
Yeah, they will make information available on our website, ramseycounty.com/public-hearing. So
they're not going to respond to individual comments?
Not this evening. The whole point is for them to listen.
But, I mean, are they going to respond to individual comments later on, or? I mean, who's running the meeting tonight? Are you running the meeting, or is this
a
meeting?
I'm running the meeting. Our county commissioners are really running the meeting. But do you have a comment that you would like to make? You're welcome to.
Yeah, well, I want to hear, I wanted to hear some more of the other comments because I came in late, sir.
All right, that's
but
okay.
But, you know, I would appreciate it if somebody would respond. Yeah, what is your position? Are you with the...
At the beginning, they explained the format. Okay. And the responses aren't coming tonight. Yeah. So this is just a spot for us to be heard.
Okay.
And then later, I am interested to get a one-on-one, actually, like you are, but they explained at the beginning, and that's how it is.
Okay, and what is your position, sir?
I work in training and development for our health and wellness service team. So just here this evening tonight, want to help moderate, and I want to keep things moving. So if you have comments, we'll come back to you. Other comments from anyone else? Make sure we don't lose anyone. Yes, sir.
Hi, my name is John Husbeck, and I've been looking at this statement for about a week since I got it. The increases are double-digit all the way down the whole statement. I look at this and try to figure out, what do we get? I mean, we keep talking about all the things that are going up. I hear a few people say ours went down 1%. So are we, listening to all these people here, carrying the rest of them based on market values? I don't get it. And I never hear from any of you about what you're going to cut. My budget is fixed unless I go out and get a second job. I don't have the ability to go to my neighbor and say, I need 10 or 20% of your money because I have a spending problem. And it seems that we have a spending problem. And I get tired of it, a voice that's maybe heard here, but nothing's ever done. These meetings, I don't know how beneficial they are. I'm frustrated when I look at this. And I didn't want to come up here and be completely negative, but I don't see anything positive about this until you guys act and work to reduce the cost that you're laying on all of these people in here. Because I don't see anybody in here, I haven't heard anybody that came up here and said, thank you. Mine went down 5% this year. And if they don't speak, they're probably looking at a tax statement like mine, 19.3%. Look in the mirror and look at the people here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Looking for other comments.
Township. There's a neighborhood with a lot of single family homes and just kind of twin homes and pretty modest dwellings. I just own my house. It's pretty simple. My property tax will be going up 30%, and I don't remember this ever happening before. And I missed the first part, so I'm sorry about that. I also have other things like problems with my water being rusty, wrecking my water purifier, wrecking my clothes. I don't understand a couple of things. One is, why does something go up so dramatically and there's no warning or like planning to be able to handle that? And like the other gentleman said, what are we getting for that? And again, I missed the first part, so I'm sorry about that, but I just think, you know, you try to graduate stuff or make it so people can handle it, and we all plan our best and do our best, and it's just kind of shocking, I guess.
Thank you, ma'am. Just mentioned again two individual questions about property tax values. Katie, could you just raise your hand? Katie can show you where our assessors are in the back of the library, so we've mentioned that again. Other comments for our commissioners? Anyone else like to speak? Yes, please.
Hello. Rob Weisenberger, 1855 Fernwood in Roseville. Back in, I think it was in the 70s in California, they passed, I think it was Proposition 13, if you're not and you're familiar with it, good. What that was basically, when you purchased a property, correct me if I'm wrong, your taxes were based on a percentage of the purchase price, like 82%. But as long as you stayed in your property, your taxes stayed at that level. So you could budget for your taxes. It didn't go up, you know, on a whim. California seemed to manage well with that. It also maintained good ownership base, and it limited urban sprawl, which was, I think, the impetus of it. But they've managed, and I'm wondering if you'd ever consider something like that here. Again, it would allow us to budget, and it would force you to live within your means, more or less. So that was one suggestion. Second one, if we abolish the Met Council, I think you'd save a lot of money.
Appreciate your comments. Thank you.
My name is Mark Schubel. I live at 2955 Ontario Road, Little Canada. I work in Minneapolis, and I communicated for the regain. And I was just telling my friend here, you can't go anywhere in Hennepin County and throw a cat and not hit a crane. You come over here to Ramsey County, and you folks are spending money like mad up here in Arden Hills. I mean, Bolander must be just flipping over in his grave with all the money he's making up here. You go down here to the old adult detention center, how much have we spent down there, and there's nobody developing it, looking at it? We need to start controlling some of this, stop spending, start finding some more people to generate more money.
Thank you.
I would like to make one more comment to everybody that's having a $50,000 tax increase at the end. It says on here, this is the time to provide feedback. The proposed levies is now. It also states on here that the only way you're going to do anything about it is to put it in court. I already met with the people back here, and that's basically what this is. Take them to court. So, I have them to.
Other comments? Don't want to leave anybody out. Come on up and if you could just state your name and your address and then any comments, and you have 2 minutes.
Okay, sir. In my mind, this is a disaster. Kevin Bergman, Citizen Reporter News. I can see one cut right here. I'm not sure why the property tax budget meeting with all your floors of budget people is run by the Health and Safety Department. You would think that you would have somebody, there must be somebody in here from the budget department. I mean, I'm looking at this coming forward, and all I see is no comment. I'm wondering, who is the chair of this board? Wow. It looks like the chair didn't make the meeting. I think this is the only, is this the only public meeting this board has had for any kind of public input since September 12th? What a disaster. A complete disaster. But I know what it's about. It's about secrecy. Now, when you're talking about transparency, I see very little transparency. Are you talking about you have an aspiration of transparency? Or are you thinking that you have what we see here tonight, the charade? Is this complete transparency or absolute transparency? All I see is secrecy. I mean, there's not even a microphone for people to speak in front of. There's not even a thing for people to hold their papers in front of. I can't believe that a big county like this is operated in this fashion. This is unbelievable. We know Ramsey County has a huge, deplorable debt. A lot of it did from that big failure in St. Paul on that Union Station and all that sort of thing. When are you going to talk about this unbelievable debt? And you know, that doesn't mention all kinds of other failures in St. Paul. Hopefully your son, Ms. Mayor, will be able, you and your husband will be able to, and him can get together and do something about doing something in St. Paul, because St. Paul is a disaster. Good luck. Now, I know there's a lot of secrecy. I know, Mr. McDonough, we've seen on TV, you have your secrets. We know Al Franken has his secrets. We know Betty McCollum has her secrets, along with her chief of staff, Bill Harper. And my question is, when are you going to open this up so you don't have all these meetings where you actually talk very glibly in the back room and at least put them on your discussions and all the many things you have to say on at least TV if you're not going to let anybody speak? I can't even believe.
Thank you. I'm sorry,
now, sir, who decided on 2 minutes? I mean, I haven't even got into the budget. Right. How can you talk about the budget of Ramsey County in 2 minutes? Did you make the decision, sir?
I didn't, but I want to do my best to hold to it, so I'm going to have to call time.
And, sir, who did make the decision?
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Okay, did you make the decision?
We're going to call time on your comments, but thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. I'm going to ask if there's any other comments. We, again, don't want to leave anyone out, but we won't go beyond when...
My name is Sean. I'm in favor of the House of 1128 Selby. I'm in St. Paul. So, the format, cool enough, it works. I'm very interested, I don't know if this is available to be known prior to coming in here. I'm a newcomer to civics. I had a lobby to have had some time to see some. The increase that's hit from St. Paul, where Mr. Carter's going to be, here, the tax levy for the schools, what else there was. Yeah, it's extravagant. It's insane. The thing to think about are, is there controlled spending? I know I moved to a different community. I still have a house in St. Paul. The impact of these races on the people that I rent to, it's going to be specific. Either that or the maintenance budget or the improvements budget for that property goes down. And so the property goes down or the people have unaffordable housing, you know, moving in one of those directions. But I think about where I do live. So I live out in Chanhassen, and the people that I commute with on a daily basis, the difference in temperature of the people generally tends to be financially conservative people who, where my people have means. They don't spend a lot of money, I would say, kind of as a philosophy. The feeling I've got, the feeling I've got is that the people that the Ramsey County has a little bit easier time spending money. There's a little bit more of a parade behind, let's do this, let's buy that, let's do this. And it seems like a little bit less control over spending in general. So that's something. It's markedly different. I feel like the services I get where I live at are very tangibly better. A lot less. I pay the same for a house that's twice as much. The two, the one, okay. Anyway, I'm interested to know where there's a chance to have a back and forth as well. It's very unsatisfying. This sounds like something we could do on Facebook together. Did you guys have the property tax increase too? Yes, I did. Are you mad about it? Yes, I am. I'd like to have the department use a discussion. However, I'm a late camera on how this works. Maybe that exists already, but if it doesn't, please put it in place.
Thank you. Anyone else that would like to make a comment?
Sir, are you taking other comments?
We give everyone 2 minutes, so.
And that's it, no follow-up?
That's right.
A disaster.
We do have a ton of cards. You may fill one of those out. Anybody who's more comfortable doing that, we have those available as well. The rail.
No, you don't. You're not responding to anybody here. Are you going to respond to people in their comment cards?
Yes, we will.
Well, sir, who do you speak for, sir?
I'm going to ask. I'm going to ask, we can talk to you after the meeting, but I'm going to ask, I want to keep control of the meeting and be fair to everyone in the room. So I'm going to ask, are there any other comments or questions? Anyone that would like to get up and make that comment?
A single answer to that question would be good to hear. I don't know the answer to that yet. Let's do that.
Last call for any comments.
I had 15 seconds left of my 2 minutes.
Yield to the gentleman.
Anytime you hear affordable housing and affordable health care, just means the money is being shifted from your pocket to theirs to somebody else. So just remember that there is no thing as affordable housing. It is what it is. If you people have rental property, Section 8, I don't know if that comes out of Ramsey County or the state, but when people are on Section 8, they have to pay for rent through the county or the state, and you have to raise the amount of rent because your property taxes went up, it's just doing that. So no such thing as affordable housing and affordable health care.
This will be just a last call here. Not wanting to leave anyone out, and yet we'll close the public hearing if there aren't any comments from anyone who hasn't spoken. I'm going to turn to Commissioner Repin. Did you want to close the public hearing or any final comments?
My final comments are several of us will be staying around as well as some of the staff are available. And you're going to still make sure that the assessors are staying and so we are here. And I really appreciate, I took notes on every person reading and I do appreciate. And all of us appreciate very much, and I'm just representing the chair of the board, but we really appreciate you coming and sharing these things.
Ma'am, could you point out the members who you're talking about who are taking staff? Could you, they stand up and introduce themselves? Are we to talk to the health department there or the wellness department? Or who are we to talk to?
Several staff members throughout as well as health.
Yeah, but could they identify themselves, Ms. Chair?
They already did in the beginning of the meeting.
We all know.
Well, I don't need to talk to the health department.
Thank you very much.